Hi everyone. My name is Metin Özen. I am fourth grade student at Ege University Mechanical Engineering Department. Introduction to Nanoscience and Nanotechnology. This presentation is Nanotechnology in Energy Applications. What we will examine today. Contents: What is nano? Nanotechnology and Nanoscience. Potential impacts of nanotechnology. Nanotechnology in energy applications, clean and sustainable energy applications, solar cells, solar energy collection and conversion, solar energy for electricity production, photovoltaic technology, nanotechnology in batteries, other nanotechnology applications, advantages and disadvantages of nanotechnology resources. What is nano? Nano, a prefix that means very, very small. How small is nano? 1 billionth of something or blah blah. Nanotechnology. Nanotechnology is manipulation of matter on atomic, molecular and supramolecular scale. Nanoscience. Nanoscience is the study of structures and materials on an ultra small scale. A nanometer is 1 billionth of a meter. The physical and chemical properties of matter change at the nano level. Nanoscience. The study and manipulation of materials at the nanoscale. The nanoscience revelation will lead to new areas of research, better understanding of matter and interactions, new ways to tackle important problems in science. Potential impacts of nanotechnology. Health. Diagnostics, cancer treatment and targeted drug delivery. Materials, sports industry, cosmetics, clothing and space elevators. Technology, faster processing, morphing, computers and smaller, more powerful mobile devices. Environment, cleaner energy, better energy storage and treatment of water. Nanotechnology in energy applications. Over the past 50 decades, the fields of science and engineering have been seeking to develop new and improved types of energy technologies that have the capacity of improving life all over the world. In order to make the next leap forward from the current generation of technology, science and engineers have been developing energy applications of nanotechnology. Nanotechnology, a new field in science, is any technology that contains components smaller than 100 nanometers. For scale, a single virus particle is about 100 nanometers in width. An important side field of nanotechnology related to energy is nanofabrication. Nanofabrication is the process of designing and creating devices on the nanoscale. Creating devices smaller than 100 nanometers opens many doors for the development of new ways to capture, store, and transfer energy. The inherent level of control that nanofabrication would give science and engineers would be critical in providing the capability of solving many of the problems that the world is facing today related to current generation of energy technologies. People in the fields of science and engineering have already begun developing ways of utilizing nanotechnology for the development of consumer products. Benefits already observed from the design of these products are an increased efficiency of lighting and heating, increased electrical storage capacity, and a decrease in the amount of pollution from the use of energy. Benefits such as this make the investment of capital in the research and development of nanotechnology a top priority. Here are some interesting ways that are being explored using nanotechnology to produce more efficient and cost-effective energy. Generating steam from sunlight, producing high-efficiency light bulbs, increasing the electricity generated by windmills, generating electricity from waste heat, storing hydrogen for fuel cell powered cars, Clothing that generates electricity, reducing friction to reduce the energy consumption, reducing power loss in electric transmission wires, reducing the cost of solar cells, improving the performance of batteries, improving the efficiency and reducing the cost of fuel cells, making the production of fuels from raw materials more efficient. Nanotechnologies provide the potential to enhance energy efficiency across all brands of industry and to economically leverage renewable energy production through new technological solutions and optimized production technologies. Nanotechnology innovations could impact each part of the value-added chain in the energy sector. Energy source, energy chains, energy distribution, energy storage, energy use. Energy source, regenerative fossil fuels, nuclear. Energy chains, gas turbines, thermoelectrics, fuel cells, hydrogen generation, combustion engines, electrical motors. Energy distributions, power transmission, smart grids, heat transfer. Energy storage, electrical energy, chemical energy, thermal energy. Energy use, thermal insulation, air conditioning, light wheel construction, industrial process, lighting. Energy source. Nanotechnologies provide essential improvement potential for the development of both conventional energy sources and renewable energy sources like geothermal energy, sun, wind, water, tides, or biomass. Energy conversion, the conversion of primary energy source into electricity, heat, and kinetic energy requires utmost efficiency. Efficiency increases especially in fossil-free gas and steam power plants, could help avoid considerable amounts of carbon dioxide emissions. Energy distributions, regarding the reduction of energy losses in current transmission, hope exists that the extraordinary electric conductivity of nanomaterials like carbon nanotubes can be utilized for application in electric cables and power lines. Energy storage. The utilization of nanotechnologies for the enhancement of electrical energy storage like batteries and supercapacitors turns out to be downright promising. Energy use. To achieve sustainable energy supply and parallel to the optimized development of available energy source, it is necessary to improve the efficiency of energy use and to avoid unnecessary energy consumptions. Clean and sustainable energy applications. Renewable energy can be defined as one type of energy source which can be provide light, electricity and heat without polluting the environment. Nowadays, there is a huge interest in this subject since it is expected to provide 50% of the world's primary energy by 2040. Moreover, renewable energy can be play a crucial role to reduce gas emissions to the environment by about 70%. During 2050. From the other side, a new science field grown quickly, which is called nanotechnology, has much and considerable attention in the recent years due to many engineering and technology applications. For example, the nanomaterials can be used to reduce size information processing parts of most usable devices such as cell phones and lab computers. Scientists refer to this dimensional range of 1 to 100 nanometer as the nanoscale, and materials at this scale are called nanocrystals or nanomaterials. Therefore, this reduction in size leads to reduce their required energy. Also, there are many benefits which can be observed from the design of nanotechnology-based products for renewable energy, which are 1. An increased efficiency of lighting and heating. 2. Increased electrical storage capacity. 3. A. Decreased in the amount of pollution from the energy using. 4. Nanotechnology will generate 2.5 trillion dollar. Furthermore, nanotechnology can be used to improve renewable energy source. For example, wind energy efficiency can be improved by using light, more strength nanomaterials for rotor blades. In biomass energy using nano-based precisions, forming to optimize crop use produce biofuels. This picture, high strength and electrical conductive CNT composites could be applied in rotor blades of wind generators. Nanocoatings can be used to prevent the corrosion in tidal energy equipments, while nanocomposites are utilized to make drilling machines in geothermal energy more fatigue resistant. This picture, principle of a solar thermal parabolic through power point. Solar cells, solar energy collection and conversion. Solar energy is free and readily available in many parts around the world. In just one year, the sun can provide the earth with 15,000 times more energy than the atomic and fuel energy actually needed during the year. This energy source can be used in different ways: photovoltaic technology, which directly converts light into electrical current, solar thermal systems used in solar collectors, artificial foil tanks, which produces either carbon hydrates or hydrogen via water splitting, the so-called passive solar technologies, where building design maximizes solar lighting and heating, and even biomass technology, where plants use the solar radiation to drive chemical transformation and create compilation carbon hydrates, which are used to produce electricity, steam or biofuels. All these energy-related processes and their applications are enclosed in the so-called solar economy. This picture, evolution of photovoltaic technology from conventional to nanostructured solar cells. Conventional solar cells, nanostructured solar cells. Solar energy for electric production, photovoltaic technology. PV solar cells are devices which produce electricity from the sun radiation by means of the photoelectric effect. The photons from light are converted into electrical current. The inclusion of nanoscale components in PV cells is a way to reduce some limitations. First, the ability to control the energy bandgap provides flexibility and interchangeability. Second, nanostructured materials enhance the effective optical path and significantly decrease the probability of charge recombination. This picture, schema of solar water splitting, a system of composite polycrystalline. Nanotechnology in batteries. How can nanotechnology improve batteries? Using nanotechnology in the manufacture of batteries offers the following benefits: increasing the available power from a battery and decreasing the time required to recharge a battery. These benefits are achieved by coating the surface of an electrode with nanoparticles. This increases the surface area of electrode therapy, allowing more current to flow between the electrode and chemicals inside the battery. This technique could increase the efficiency of hybrid vehicles by significantly reducing the weight of the batteries needed to provide adequate power. Increasing the shelf life of battery bank using nanomaterials to separate liquids in the battery from the solid electrodes when there is no draw on the battery. This separation prevents the low-level discharge that occurs in a conventional battery, which increases the shelf life of the battery dramatically. Batteries, nanotechnology applications under development. Researchers at Purdue University have demonstrated an electrode made with antimony in a shape they call nanoshine, They have shown that lithium-ion batteries with these electrodes charge faster than lithium-ion batteries with graphite electrodes. Researchers at Chalmers University have demonstrated the use of graphene oxide aerogel used as electrode in lithium-sulfur batteries. Their data shows that this method may increase the lifetime of lithium-sulfur batteries. Researchers at Rice University are using carbon nanotube films to stop growth of dendrites on lithium metal anodes. This stiff way may help develop lithium metal batteries, which could have much higher capacity and faster charging than lithium-ion batteries. Other nanotechnology applications: producing high-efficiency light bulbs. A nano-engineered polymer matrix is used in one style of high-efficiency light bulbs. The new bulbs have the advantage of being shatterproof and twice the efficiency of compact fluorescence light bulbs. Other researchers developing high-efficiency LEDs using arrays of nano-sized structures called prismatic cavities. Another idea under development is to update incandescent light bulbs by surrounding the conventional filament with crystalline materials that convert some of the waste infrared radiation into visible light, increasing the electricity generated by white mass. An epoxy containing carbon nanotubes is being used to make white mass blades. Stronger and lower weight blades are made possible by the use of nanotube filled epoxy. The resulting longer blades increase the amount of electricity generated by each wind mile. Generating electricity from waste heat. Researchers have used sheets of nanotubes to build thermocells that generate electricity when the sides of the cell are at different temperatures. These nanotube sheets could be wrapped around hot pipes, such as the exhaust pipe of your car, to generate electricity from heat that is usually wasted. Storing hydrogen for fuel cell powered cars. Researchers have prepared graphene layers to increase the binding energy of hydrogen to the graphene surface in a fuel tank, resulting in a higher amount of hydrogen storage and therefore a lighter weight fuel tank. Other researchers have demonstrated that sodium borohybride nanoparticles can effectively store hydrogen, clothing that generates electricity. Researchers have developed piezoelectric nanofibers that are flexible enough to be woven into clothing. The fibers can turn normal motion into electricity to power your cell phone and other mobile electronic devices, reducing friction to reduce the energy consumptions. Researchers have developed lubricants using inorganic buckybulbs that significantly reduce friction, improving the efficiency and reducing the cost of fuel cells. Nanotechnology is being used to reduce the cost of catalysts used in fuel cells. These catalysts produce hydrogen ions from fuels such as methanol. Nanotechnology is also being used to improve the efficiency of membranes used in fuel cells to separate hydrogen ions from other gases such as oxygen, making the production of fuels from raw materials more efficient. Nanotechnology can address the shortage of fossil fuels such as diesel and gasoline by making the production of fuels from low-grade raw materials economical. Nanotechnology can also be used to increase the mileage of ants and make the production of fuels from normal raw materials more efficient. This picture examples for potential applications of nanotechnology along the value added chain in the energy sector. Nanostructured heat protection layers for gas turbines, high temperature superconductor for motors and generators in ships, non-optimized fuel cells for automobiles and transport vehicles, nanomembranes for separation of carbon dioxide in CCC, nanocrystalline magnetic materials for efficient components in current transformation and supply, nanofrost hydrogen storage materials for fuel cell vehicles, lithium-ion batteries for stationary energy storage or as power unit for hybrid electric cars, carbon nanotubes as high tensile concentration materials for rotor blades of wind power stations or as material for loss cables power lines, polymer solar cells for large-scale applications in buildings or for mobile electronics, dye solar cells as decorative facade elements in buildings, nanostructured thermoelectric materials for power supply of mobile electronics, OLED for large-scale displays and lighting devices, nanostructured wear protection layers for machine components with a high mechanical load. Advantages and disadvantages of nanotechnology. While nanotechnology is seen as the way of the future and is a technology that a lot of people think will bring a lot of benefit for all who will be using it, nothing is ever perfect and there will always be pros and cons to everything. The advantages and disadvantages of nanotechnology can be easily enumerated and here are some of them. Advantages of nanotechnology. To enumerate the advantages and disadvantages of nanotechnology, let us first run through the good things this technology brings. Nanotechnology can actually revolutionize a lot of electronic products, procedures and applications. The areas that benefit from the continued development of nanotechnology when it comes to electronic products include nanotransistors, nanodiodes, OLED, plasma displays, quantum computers, and many more. Nanotechnology can also benefit the energy sector, the development of more effective energy processing, energy absorbing, and energy storage products in smaller and more efficient devices is possible with this technology. Such items like batteries, fuel cells, and solar cells can be built smaller but can be made to be more effective with this technology. Another industry that can benefit from nanotechnology is the manufacturing sector that will need materials like nanotubes, aerogels, nanoparticles and other similar items to produce their products with. These materials are often stronger, more durable and lighter than those that are not produced with the help of nanotechnology. In the medical world, nanotechnology is also seen as a boon since this can help with creating what is called smart drugs. These help cure people faster and without side effects that other traditional drugs have. You will also find that the research of nanotechnology in medicine is now focusing on areas like tissue regeneration, bone repair, immunity, and even cures for such ailments like cancer, diabetes, and other life-threatening diseases. Disadvantages of nanotechnology. When taking the advantages and disadvantages of nanotechnology, you will also need to point out what can be seen as the negative side of this technology. Included in the list of disadvantages of this science and its development is the possible loss of jobs in traditional forming and manufacturing industry. You will also find that the development of nanotechnology can also bring about the crash of certain markets due to lowering of the value of oil and diamonds due to possibility of developing alternative sources of energy that are more efficient and won't require the use of fossil fuels. This can also mean that since people can now develop products at the molecular level, diamonds will also lose its value since it can now be mass produced. Atomic weapons can now be more accessible and made to be more powerful and more destructive. This can also become more accessible with nanotechnology since These particles are very small problems can actually arise from the inhalation of these minute particles. Much like the problems a person gets from inhaling minute asbestos particles. Presently, nanotechnology is very example, expensive, and developing it can cost you a lot of money. It is also pretty difficult to manufacture, which is probably why products made with nanotechnology are more expensive. And my presentation is finished. This is my resources. Thanks for watching.